browser is a lightweight extension to the full Exploration Archives data management application. It provides simple GIS access to the organization's exploration data. Its intended audience is geophysical teams, business analysts, or any external users who are interested in what exploration assets are available in an area of interest. Based on an Esri platform, it has all of the GIS tools you would expect: pan, zoom, go to, identify, and layer control. It also supports more than one map. This allows your organization to set up various maps based on different projects, area of interest, or data visibility restrictions. I'll start with the seismic tab. Pick a saved spatial bookmark and select the survey in my area of interest. I'll do the same search again, but this time I'll use the text search. This highlights how you can combine both spatial and text attributes into one search result. The top grid lists selected surveys. By right mouse clicking on the grid row, I can display additional properties if needed. The additional properties, and in fact all of the grid columns, can be customized to suit your organization's needs. Selecting the survey in the upper grid will display all of the products that are available for the survey in the lower grid. The product grid allows users to sort and filter data based on category. If that's not granular enough, the advanced filter has additional capabilities. In this case, I'll use the contains clause to filter out my angle stacks. The goal here is to make it easy to find the products that I'm interested in. Based on my credentials and location, the download and view icons will be enabled. If I have permission to download data, just click on the download button to view a file. If I want to download a bunch of files, select all of them and select download from the product context menu. This will put all of the files into a download queue and download the files to your selected location in the background. If the SegWI data has been processed using the Exploration Archive SegWI utility, the SegWI scan icon will be displayed. The SegWI scan function allows users to view images of the SegWI data even if they don't have download access to the file or the file isn't online. The SegWI scan will display a live trace outline, time section, time slice, a detailed SegWI volume report listing properties like sample rate, data format, inline and crossline count, CDP interval spacing, and so on. And finally, we extract and save the EBCDIC header as a separate SegWI volume attribute. If the data is offline or unavailable, field data for example, users can create a data request. The data request can be routed to the data management team responsible for fulfilling the order. Select the products you are interested in and add them to your cart. When you are done adding products, open the cart tab and proceed to the checkout to complete the data request. Here, users can add additional information like request type, priority, internal ordering codes, and delivery information. For example, you may be sending gather data to a processor. And finally, for those organizations managing their own data sales, there are fields for entering sales information. If you have any special instructions or files that you would like to include with the data request, they can be added using the Notes section. When you are done, simply place the order. The Exploration Archive's back office functions can be set up to notify the data management team that a data request has been placed. Automated tasks can also be kicked off to prepare and QC the data. Users will be notified as their data request moves through the various workflow steps. Well data is handled exactly the same way. I'll select the well tab, go to the spatial bookmark, select some wells from the map, and you can download files, add to cart, or bundle files for delivery. The Exploration Archives browser is also easy to modify if your organization has any special requirements. In this example, Pulse Seismic, a multi-client data provider, wanted a public portal to display the data they have available for license. From their public website, I'll launch the Exploration Archives browser. Zoom to an area of interest. Select some 2D and 3D data. Display additional details about the surveys I've selected. And when I'm satisfied with my selection, proceed to the checkout. To place a data request, all I need to enter is my name, company, email, and telephone number. When the order is placed, the sales team at Pulse is notified and will follow up with a prospective client. I'll wrap up this demonstration with a quick summary. The Exploration Archives browser is an enterprise-wide web application that allows exploration teams, analysts, or even external clients to quickly find and order exploration assets. It is built on an Esri platform so it can integrate with other GIS services and data your organization may provide. It supports all types of well and seismic data. With the appropriate permission, users can automatically download data one file at a time or bundle a bunch of files together for automatic delivery. And finally, the Exploration Archives browser can be customized to your organization's unique requirements without compromising other Exploration Archives modules or functions.